Hey everyone, how's it going today? Coach Alvarez here, back at you with another episode, Coffee with Coach. Hope you're up, doing well. Got the mind in the right place, and not as always, let's put it in the right place. I want to share with you guys, I've been listening to a bunch of different videos on Atomic Habits, all right? If you haven't heard of that, it's a book by James Clear, and I'm just really getting into it because of all the different ways to just create better patterns and things to help you get to a specific goal. And there's a lot of really good information in these videos and in this book. And one thing I wanted to share today that kind of goes with like the episode yesterday about am I good enough, or like just so many people that I deal with throughout the weeks and months and years of jiu-jitsu and coaching is helping people get to a goal. Because most people, when they come in, they have some type of goal that they have in mind, but they don't have any idea how they're going to get there. They just want to be a different person, whether they want to lose weight, they want to be able to defend themselves better, they want to be more disciplined, whatever. These are just a couple of the top things that I get from people all the time. And so they have a goal, but they don't have a system in place to get there. And it goes along with like tournaments, okay? This is huge because with the conversation I had with my student and the team the other day was, you know, well, I want to compete, but I don't think I'm good enough. Well, how do you get good enough? You got to have a system in place. Like for instance, showing up to class on a routine, consistent basis. If you don't have a routine or a habit of coming to class, it's going to be very, very hard to get good in jiu-jitsu. That's the first step. The second step is, you know, what techniques are you going to use to get you to the goal that you want to get to the submission? Because the end goal is the submission. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to submit each other. That's how you win. I mean, you win by submission, and if you can't submit your opponent, then you win on points. But the ultimate goal, and all the best guys and ladies in jiu-jitsu are trying to submit their opponents. They're not trying to just win on points. So how do you get to those wins? How do you get to that victory? You get there by having a game plan in place. You know, I was giving this example last night with my team, and I give it quite often about, you know, your route that you take from your home to work and then work to home. You know, once you've established that route and you've been going to that place of employment or wherever it is that you go to for so long, it just becomes second nature. You know what streets to take, what exit to get off of, whatever. Like, you don't need your phone to give you directions because you just know how to get there. Once you've established that route, then it's just second nature, and you can daydream, you can think about other things, and then you just end up at work or you end up back at home. So jiu-jitsu is no different. You have to have, or any goal, you have to have a system, a route that you're going to take to get you to that end goal. Because how many people have you heard say, well, like for instance, they got a wedding or some vacation that they're getting ready to take, and I want to lose weight. I want to lose X amount of pounds up until that point to get ready to look good in the bathing suit or the dress or the tuxedo or the suit or whatever the case is. But they never really established like how they're going to do it. They just in their mind have the end goal, but they don't have a system in place to get them to the end goal. And so without those systems, then the goal isn't going to be achieved. You know, if you just, cause I was listening to this podcast and they were talking about, if you just set the goal, like for instance, like let's say you want to win a jiu-jitsu championship or any championship, you're in sports, you're an athlete and you're trying to win something. And you just say, man, I want to win this. This is what I want to win. But you don't have a system in place to do that. The likelihood of you winning that thing isn't going to be very high. But if you focus on your practice, what you're going to practice, how you're going to do it, how many reps you're going to do, what, you know, like what days, what times, this, that, whatever. And you put all these things in place to get you to the goal. Even if you don't achieve the goal right away, the amount of improvement that you're getting along the way through the weeks, months, and the years to get there like those things are going to stick. Those things are forever with you because you've created these routes, these habits, these things that you've done over time that are just going to become second nature. And now you just become that much better. And I can vouch for that because the things that I've put in place to help me win certain championships, you know, all the tournaments that I've won, it's never, you know, I'm gonna go out there and just wing it. You know, I'm just gonna go out there and just see what happens. If I was to think like that and have a mindset like that, I very doubt or doubt highly if I would win anything. But I've won a lot because I know what I'm going to do when I get out there, when I shake hands and, you know, bump fists with my opponent. I know what I'm trying to do before I get out there. I have in my mind the game plan that I want to do. And the game plan becomes so good that it becomes very hard to stop regardless of who it is. And then you just start going through your system when you're out there, and then you just start winning more and more tournaments. But the students that I see or that I deal with the most, that when they don't have a system in place, how they're going to lose weight, how they're going to cut the, you know, how they're going to cut the weight, how they're going to eat healthier, how they're going to, you know, what game plan they're going to do. Their success rate is way lower than the students that I have or the people that I know that they know exactly what they're going to do when they get out there. You know, I've had students in the past when they get out there, they shake hands with someone and they freeze up. You know, they're like a deer in headlights. Everything that they maybe thought they were going to do, they didn't do it. Because why? They didn't practice it in practice. They didn't put it in place. They don't have a system. Then you have those other individuals that you watch and you see. They just go out there and they just go right to work, man. And they just go to just dominating their opponents. And how do they do that? Because they're just going through. You can watch them roll and you see them as the match goes on. Like, man, they are just very good at X, Y, Z. Like, just going through these motions. And then they tap people out or they get their hand raised or whatever. And it's very clear that that individual knows exactly what they're doing versus the other individuals out there. They're out there. They're a competitor. They obviously want to win a tournament. Otherwise, they wouldn't have signed up. But they have no clue on what they're doing. I have no clue. There's students that I've had coached in the past. I have no idea what they were doing. Like, nothing. Like, I just... clueless. I'm like confused on what they're trying to do. So when I'm confused on what they're trying to do, I can't help them. I can't guide them to victory because they're just all over the place with their techniques. They're before I even get a chance to say anything, they're off to the next thing and they didn't even, it's a mess. All right. And then you have the other students that I've had, people like next to me, where I'm coaching, and I'll have people after a match, after my student wins or something like that. I'll have someone next to me, right or left, whatever. Like, man, you guys were just like really in sync, man. It was just like, that was just really cool how you were just saying things and that person was just doing them. Because it's like a video game with a joystick. Like, I have the control and I just kind of guide that person where they need to be because they're listening. And I know their game plan. I know their system. I know what they're trying to do. And I'm the outside looking in person and I'm just giving them the little tips that they need to get to where they need to get to. And then we go out there and win. But those other ones that have no system in place, no route, no GPS, they're just no map, no, just nothing. They're just out there. We're just going to shake hands and we're going to just see what happens. Those are the most unsuccessful students that I've ever had or that I will have because I'm going to have those in the future at some point. So you have to have a system in place. How are you going to get, I'll just take this to regular life stuff off the mat. You know, if your credit isn't where it should be, how are you going to get it there? You can't just wish for an 800 credit score. You know, you actually, you know, got to start paying some things off. Which credit card are you going to pay off first? If you got multiple credit cards, which one are you going to deal with first? And what are you going to do here? What are you going to do there to get rid of these things and then slowly bring your credit up? You know, you're going to lose weight. How? How are you going to do that? What foods are you going to eat? What foods are you going to get rid of that are in your daily, weekly diet that aren't good for you? You know, and the list goes on. I'll be here all day trying to, you know, explain this, but I think you guys get the idea that just having a goal of like losing weight, a better credit score, better whatever, if there's no system in place on how you're going to do it, there's no habits that are built in that are winning successful habits, then it's going to be very hard to achieve that goal. And again, every time you go for something doesn't mean you're going to get it. But through these daily habits that you build, good habits, winning habits, successful habits, then they become you. You become them. Like it's a thing that comes together, and you eventually will get that goal. But just to say, I want to lose weight, I want to run a 5K, I want to lose weight for my wedding, for my vacation coming up, and there's no clue on how you're going to do that. You know, this guy gave an example of like someone wanting to run a marathon, and they prepared for it, but they really weren't really like a runner, you know. And so they did it and they did okay, but then after the marathon, what happened? They just stopped running. And then time goes on and they were like, oh man, I haven't ran in a long time. I haven't done a marathon. I guess I need to do another marathon to get another goal in place. So that person never had a system in place. So they just ran a marathon. Like anyone can do that. Grab a pair of tennis shoes and just go sign up and just run a marathon. But did you prepare yourself? Did you run X amount of miles a day to prepare yourself for that? And did you become that? So when the marathon is over, did you keep that pattern going? So when the next one comes, you are going to do better. You are going to have a better time or a better result because you became that person. So this atomic habits, and the reason why it's called atomic, because it's just little things, right? That just build up over time. So you have to have a system in place, some type of route that you're going to take. And for my jiu-jitsu people out there, whether you're my student or not, and you have, whether you're a competitor or not, when you're on the mat and you shake hands, you need to have a system in place on how you're going to get to the submission. How are you going to get your hand raised at the end of the round? Like I tell my students all the time, someone won or lost at the end of the round, whether it's on points, an advantage, or a submission, it's very rarely it's a tie. Someone has to win, and you need to know that. And how are you going to achieve that goal and get that victory in practice so that you can get those in tournaments if you decide to do a tournament? It starts in practice, and you have to have a system. You can't just shake hands and then just be like, well, let's roll and let's just see what happens. Those are the most unsuccessful students, the most unsuccessful people that I know on and off the mats, where they just wing things and have no roadmap on how they're going to get to where they're going to get to. I've gave that example before, like, you know, now you have your phone. We have GPS back in the day when I came from Texas or when I came from Michigan. I actually had to pull out a map and take a highlighter and mark the route and what exits I was going to take, the highways I was going to take from Michigan to here. And I would make that drive the first couple of years. And obviously I stopped making that drive. I won't ever make that drive anymore. I'll fly. I don't care how much a ticket costs. I'll fly before I drive back home again. But anyways, I needed that map. I needed that highlighter to show me where I was going to go. You need your phone these days. What if your phone dies or your charger isn't working anymore and your phone dies and you don't know how to get to wherever you're trying to get to and you've never been there before? Now you got to stop and ask directions, and maybe they give you the right directions, maybe they don't, but it's going to take a lot longer for you to get there versus if you just had the exact route and exactly how to get there and then practice that route, and then eventually that's just going to happen. That goal is going to happen because you have a system in place on how you're going to do that. So habits, your routine, and you know, all the little small things that need to be there in order for you to achieve that goal. So it's really good stuff. I wanted to share it with you guys. Gotta go, gotta head up to the school. Catch you guys on the next one.